What's up, guys? I hope you're having a fantastic end to your weekend. Enjoying the third episode of The Last Dance. Got it on in the background right now. And I hope you enjoyed my NFL draft coverage. It was kind of nice to have some actual sports to talk about. And I think a lot of people, a lot of teams succeeded. But now we will return to Best of Brave series. And today will be Charlie Clutch, Charlie Culberson. And he had just a flair for the dramatic since donning a Braves uniform. And even prior to that, he had the final call for Vin Scully at Dodger Stadium was a walk-off homer against the Rockies, of course. And then he walked off, I believe, the San Diego Padres in 2017 to clinch the NL West. I could be mistaken on that, but I know he hit a walk-off to clinch the NL West recently. And so he just has that knack. And not only that, he is a A-plus person and just a great clubhouse guy. And just overall, what you want he's just a baseball player. And that's the best compliment any athlete can get in any sport, to be honest with you. The versatility is just absolutely amazing. So this was a fun list to put together for me. Pretty easy because Charlie just has that clutch gene that every athlete wants to have. But number five for me in his best of is how he became a Brave. It was the salary dump trade or to create financial flexibility, trading Matt Kemp back to the Dodgers for Scott Kazmir, Brandon McCarthy, Adrian Gonzalez, and the perceived throw-in, even though I don't really like that term, even though it's kind of endearing to athletes, especially when they really succeed for their new team. It's just kind of like, ha, gotcha. But I think they added Charlie Culberson because of the severe amount of cash they had to send to us to offset Matt Kemp's salary and whatnot. But that move helped both escalate the rebuild in financial flexibility, but also gave us a great versatile piece to our roster that we've used very effectively over the years. And Charlie Culberson has been one of the best trades that we've made in our history, I could argue, with the amount of clutch moments he's had with the bat and the glove. So that's why that one's number five. Number four is just simply his versatility. He can play all the infield positions and the corner outfield positions. He's our emergency catcher. And when we are getting blown out, he is the reliever position player pitching that we go to. And he's not too shabby at that either. 90 and moving. He's just that kind of guy that even when things aren't going that great, if you're getting blown out and he comes in, has a clean inning like he's done a couple of times recently, it just makes you feel better about it. You just move on, wipe the slate clean. And Charlie's that type of person for the entire clubhouse as well. So I think when Charlie Culberson's injury happened in Washington last year, even though we went on to win the NL East and compete in the playoffs and really had a good chance, I think that took the wind out of our sails and hamstrung our roster because we eventually lost Yoan Camargo to the shin issue, Charlie to the face issue, and it kind of, our versatility and with Freddie's elbow acting up the way it did, I think if we had Charlie Culberson, we could have manipulated our roster in a better way and put us in a better position to succeed, even with Charlie, even with Freddie Freeman's elbow. But again, that's why I think Charlie Culberson's kind of the glue, because he can play so many positions, because of his attitude, because of his willingness to do anything, and just how much fun he has on the baseball field. That shouldn't go unnoticed, and that's why I put that at number four. Number three is his walk-off against the Washington Nationals. It was in 2018 off of Tanner Roark. It was the beginning of the Charlie Clutch era in Atlanta, kind of, because that same week he had a couple of other walk-offs that I will talk about, but off Tanner Roark, just absolutely crushed a pitch to have us win 4-2, just take 3 out of 4 against Washington in that series, and that kind of catapulted us to the first division title, and just felt that series, it felt like, yeah, we got this, we belong, and Charlie Culberson was in the middle of it all, and that was just fantastic. Number two was the walk-off homer against Seth Lugo of the Mets, and again, that was, I think, the day game of a day-night doubleheader, and what I remember about this one is he hit a ball, I think a pitch prior, 9 miles foul, and I was like, in my head, oh no, he missed it, and he said that exact same thing in his interview. He's like, ah, I missed my one, and then luckily, Seth Lugo hung a curveball. He didn't miss that one, and crushed it over the wall for a walk-off, and just kind of, just having that kind of week is a dream come true. And I don't know if this is still accurate, but at some point, half of Charlie Culberson's career homers were walk-offs. So that's just a video game-like dream come true that you can't write. And that's the thing that I love about baseball. Anybody can come up clutch any day, anytime. And Charlie has that gene and that clutch, he just doesn't let anything, he doesn't let the moment get too big for him. He just plays the game of baseball the right way. And then number one is obviously the throw heard around the world. Charlie Clutch, bases loaded, no outs. Luke Jackson had the typical adventures of Luke Jackson inning. A lot of soft contact hits that probably shouldn't have been hits, but it's just how Luke Jackson goes. And then Charlie coming off the bench cold as a defensive sub, caught the ball on the line and was throwing the wrong way, but an absolute missile 95 miles an hour straight to the plate for the best double play in regular season baseball history. Probably one of the best top five double plays I've ever seen. Absolutely lost it. One of my favorite videos I did last year. And to do that, bases loaded, no outs, and a tie ball to keep the lead, just absolutely incredible. And to do it coming off the bench cold, even better. Charlie is just a special, special player, special person. As always, go Braves. Can't wait till baseball comes back.